Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial on Autodesk AutoCAD. In just 13 minutes, you're going to see everything you need to know to start making your first 2D and 3D drawings with it. AutoCAD is one of the best CAD software to realize 2D and 3D professional drawings for both Windows and Mac OS. It is available either under a monthly or yearly subscription plan or through limited sessions or tokens in case you don't use AutoCAD quite often. When you open AutoCAD, the start page opens showing online resources, your most recent projects made, and several news and tips from Autodesk. Go to open any project you have, or go to New to start with a new blank project by using different templates. In this video, we are going to use the default one called acad.dwt. The new project opens on the main interface under a new drawing tab on top. You can always come back to the start page with its tab. Around the big preview, you get the ribbon on top, collecting all the tools and features within AutoCAD. Several visualization tools on the right, and further options and the command line at the bottom. You can change the ribbon size with the Minimize button on top, and show, hide any tool from the View tab. Let's start with 2D drawing. Any new project starts with a 2D preview, with a Gizmo system in the bottom left corner showing the X-axis as a red line representing the horizontal direction and the Y-axis as a green line representing the vertical direction. These two define the ground plane, which is where you drop all your 2D drawings. The Draw section, under the Home tab, collects all the tools to draw in 2D. Some of these have different ways to draw an object that you can check by hovering over any button for some time. In this video, we will follow the default ways to make any drawing. Enable the line or the polyline tool and click twice on the preview to drop a straight segment. You can go on drawing others as long as you do not use the escape key. At this point, the tool gets disabled, but you can enable it again with the Enter key. Whereas, use the Circle tool to drop a circle with 2 points, and the Arc tool to make arcs with 3 points. Also, these tools get disabled once the drawing is made, so use the Enter key to go on. With the Rectangle and the Polygon tool, set the number of sides, apply with the Enter key, and fix 2 points to drop a regular shape. Whereas, enable the Ellipse tool to drop an ellipse with 3 different points. While drawing any object, AutoCAD shows a live preview of it with useful measurements on it. You can undo the drawing in progress with the Escape key. You get angle degrees in respect to the X-axis and length measurements following the unit set for the whole project. You can adjust the unit to use by typing units and applying with the Enter or the Spacebar key. Then set the unit, format, and the precision you like most. While drawing, you can also type any precise value and use the Tab key to apply and set the next value. Then use the Enter key to go on with the next drawing step. AutoCAD comes with several drawing aids collected in the bottom right corner. With Grid Mode, you can turn on or off the drawing grid and use Snap Mode to enable or disable snappings to it while drawing. Use Ortho Mode to draw only through the horizontal or the vertical axis direction. Moreover, you can enable Object Snap to get snappings to several object key points selected from the list next to the Snap button. These include Object Endpoints, centers, but also midpoints, intersections, and perpendicular directions, all shown in green color. The same key points are used to drop dashed guidelines to extend directions and extract other key points. You can also use your keyboard and the command line at the bottom to ease your drawings. For example, you can enable the polyline tool by simply typing polyline and using the enter or the spacebar key to apply. Moreover, the command line shows several options available, highlighted with blue letters. For example, you can enable arc by typing A and using the spacebar key to drop a curved side, and type L to enable line and come back to a straight side. You can do the same thing with the up and down arrow keys, choosing the right option from the list. These are the same ones you find on the command line. When you have no drawing tools on, the cursor is in selection mode, showing a small square on its center. In this mode, you can click on any object to select it and turn it in blue color, ready to get edited. Use Control or Command and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste the object, and the Delete key to remove the object. If you make any mistake, you can undo all with Control or Command and Z. The selected object shows several nodes you can use to edit it. If it is a line, an arc, a circle, or an ellipse, click and drag from its central node to move it and use the others to resize it as you like. You can also hover over any node to get useful information and additional options, such as stretch to move any endpoint, lengthen to adjust the line or arc length, and radius to change the arc radius. When selecting polylines, rectangles, and polygons, you get big and smaller nodes. Click on the big ones to move, add, or remove the selected vertex, and click on the smaller ones to manage the sides. Use stretch to move the side, add vertex to add a new vertex, and convert to arc or line to turn the side into a curve or a straight segment. Consider that selections are always cumulative unless you use the escape key to deselect all. Inside Home, Modify, you get several tools to edit your 2D drawings. For example, select any drawing and enable the Move tool to move it, the Rotate tool to rotate it, specifying rotation point and angle, and the Scale tool to scale the object without deforming it. You can also edit multiple objects together by selecting all of these first. You can click on these singularly, or click and hold while dragging to select loads of drawings with the lasso. If you drag from the left to the right, you make a window lasso, selecting all objects fully included within the blue area. If you do the same from the right to the left, you make a crossing lasso, selecting all objects touched by the green area. You can check your project from different points of view. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out around your cursor and enable the pan tool on the right and click and drag to pan around. Use the escape key to finish. Whereas, use the arrows above the 3D view cube to rotate by 90 degrees and click and drag its circumference to 2D rotate freely. Now let's see how to make simple 3D drawings. First of all, switch to a 3D preview by either clicking on any vertex or side of the 3D view cube, or using the orbit command to 3D rotate. Any 3D preview shows all the 2D drawings laying on the XY ground plane and an additional Z blue axis representing the height or depth. At this point, you can show all the 3D tools by right-clicking on top and going to Show Tabs, 3D Tools. The 3D drawing tools are all collected under the modeling section. For example, enable the box tool to create a 3D box by defining its base on the XY ground plane and then its extrusion through the Z-axis. Or else enable the sphere tool and click and drag to drop a perfect sphere. Make sure to hover over any tool to get hints and tips on how to drop any 3D solid in detail. All 3D objects are shown with their skeleton if you use the default 2D wireframe view in the top left corner. Click on it and select other views to be able to see the 3D volume. Other tools allow to create 3D objects starting from any 2D section. Use Extrude to add extrusion to any 2D base by selecting it and applying with the Enter key. Whereas, use Revolve to create a 3D solid by rotating a 2D section. Just select the section, apply with the Enter key, and then fix two points to define the rotation axis. All these 3D solids can be edited just like 2D drawings. You can also use the Gizmo system to move, scale, and rotate towards any of the three axes. Just make sure to select the right mode from the selection section on top. To save your project, click on the A button in the top left corner and go to Save As. This makes a DWG file format that can be reopened anytime. Whereas, to export your project, go to Output and then to Export. Choose DWFX or DWF to share your drawing as a read-only AutoCAD project, or PDF to send your current preview to a printer. If you have 3D solids, you can also render these by going to Visualize, Render to Size. Check it out. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Do not lose our free playlist to learn more about AutoCAD through quick and easy steps.